हेलो, दिस इज स्वप्निल ममानी, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर, आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, महिला महाविद्यालय तासगांव। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। C++ फंक्शन पैरामीटर्स। इंफॉर्मेशन कैन बी पास्ड टू फंक्शन एज पैरामीटर्स। पैरामीटर्स एक्ट एज वेरिएबल इनसाइड द फंक्शन। पैरामीटर्स आर स्पेसिफाइड आफ्टर द फंक्शन नेम इनसाइड द पैरेंथेसिस। You can add as many parameters as you want. Just separate them with a comma. Syntax: void function name in bracket parameter 1, comma parameter 2, comma parameter 3. In curly bracket code to be executed. See, the following example has a function that takes a string called fname as parameter. When the function is called, we pass along a first name which is used inside the function to print the full name. Example is void my function string fname. See out fname. Next Raj. Integer main. My function in bracket Ram. My function in bracket Ratan. Return 0. Output of this program is Ram Raj, Ratan Raj. When a parameter is passed to the function, it is called an argument. So from the above example, fname is a parameter, while Ram and Ratan are the arguments. Now see default parameters. Default parameter can also used as a parameter value by the equal sign. If we call the function without an argument, it uses the default value. For example, void my function string country equal to Norway. Next statement is cout country. In main function integer main, the four time my function is called. First my function Sweden, my function India, third my function empty. Here Norway will be called because Norway is the default parameter of the country. Fourth, my function USA, return 0. The output of this program is Sweden, India, Norway and USA. The parameter with a default value is often known as optional parameter. From the above example, country is an optional parameter and Norway is the default value. C++ multiple parameters. Inside the function, you can add as many parameters as you want. For example, void my function in bracket string fname integer age. Next statement in the body of this function is cout fname Malhotra age years old. In main function, my function first string is Raj, comma 3. Next my function Aryan, comma 14, return 0. Output of this program is Raj Malhotra, 3 years old. Aryan Malhotra, 14 years old. There are two parameters used in this function to pass my function. First is string fname and integer age. Note that when you are working with multiple parameters, the function call must have the same number of arguments as there are parameters, and the argument must be passed in the same order. Now see the C++ return keyword. Return values. The void keyword used in the previous example indicates that the function should not return a value. If you want the function to return a value, you can use a data type such as integer, string, etc. instead of void, and use the return keyword inside the function. For example, integer my function in bracket integer x. In body of the function, return 5 plus x. Body complete. Integer main. See out my function parameter passed to this function is 3. Output of this program now 8, because 5 plus 3, because the body of this function we have written a 5 plus x, and x value is a 3 now. So 5 plus x, 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. C++ functions passed by reference. In the examples from the previous slide, we used normal variables when we passed parameters to a function. You can also pass a reference to the function. This can be useful when you need to change the value of the arguments. Now see the example, void swap nums in bracket integer address x comma integer address y in bracket integer z equal to x, x equal to y, and y equal to z. This code to swap two numbers. But here we have used the address sign, that means the reference. Now actually it swap the address values. In integer main, integer first name equal to 10, integer second num equal to 20. See out before swap. See out first num, second num. Call the function which will change the values of first num and second num. Swap nums. In bracket first num comma second num. See out after swap. See out first num, second num. Return 0. Now let's see C++ function overloading. With function overloading, multiple functions can have the same name with different parameters. For the demo, integer my function in bracket integer x, float my function in bracket float x, double my function in bracket double x comma double y. Here we can see there is the same name for the all functions, that is a my function, but we can see the different type of the signature. Instead of defining two functions that should do the same thing, it is better to overload one. In the example below, we overload the plus function to work for both integer and double. The example is integer plus function in bracket integer x comma integer y, return x plus y. Next function is double plus function in bracket double x comma double y, return x plus y. Here is the name of function is same, but parameters are different. The return function overloading is not depend on the return data type. It's only depend on the parameters used in the function. Now see the main function. Integer my number equal to plus function in bracket 8 comma 5. We have used integer numbers here. So where the integer number is passed to the functions, that function will be called here. Double my number 2 equal to plus function in bracket 4.3 comma 6.26. Here the function is called where there is double parameters are used. That means plus function in bracket double x comma double y. Now see out integer my number. Next statement is see out double my number 2. For my number 1, integer parameters function is called, and for my number 2, double parameters function is called. To get the more videos of this series, please like, share and subscribe. And please do not forget to press the bell icon to view latest videos. Thank you.